Hello everyone, this is Satvik, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can perform a passive reconnaissance on a particular target. So without getting any delay, let's start. I'm going to demonstrate this process on Kali Linux, and you can try this out on any other hacking distributions you are using. So let me open my Kali Linux. So if you don't know what the reconnaissance means, reconnaissance is the process of gathering information of a target before getting him down or exploiting him. So in order and in reconnaissance, there are two ways. The first one is active reconnaissance and the second one is a passive reconnaissance. In active reconnaissance, we gather the information with some contact with the target. Means the target, if he searches deeply, he can understand that we are finding information about him. But in passive reconnaissance, the target doesn't even know that we are gathering information about him. And guys, the target might be a domain or even a person. It can be the thing on what you are attacking. And to say that there are no good tools in order to do a passive reconnaissance on a particular target, but I found a cool framework which is written in Python which helps us in achieving this passive reconnaissance. So this is my Kali Linux, and the framework we'll be discussing about is open source research framework, or you can call it as OSRF. So in order to install this, you need to have Python 3. So in order to download the Python 3 in your Kali Linux or any other Ubuntu or any other Linux distributions, apt-get install python 3-pip. Just hit this, and since it's already downloaded, so it's not showing anything. Or else you need to hit Y and you need to wait for some time so that it gets downloaded. Downloaded and installed. So in order to install this open source research framework or open source reconnaissance framework, you have to simply do pip3 install OSR framework. So guys, I'm currently root user, and if you are not root user, then you need to add sudo in front of this command. Okay, so let me hit enter. I had already downloaded that, so let's wait for some time. Yeah, it started down. Yeah, okay. So after downloading, you need to wait for some time. I think you need to wait for some time in order to get it downloaded and get installed. Since mine already downloaded, it came up very fast. So I'm gonna clear the screen. And you can access this open source research framework or OSRF by simply hitting OSRF. Just hit enter. So my virtual machine is somewhat slower. Okay, yeah, we got the results. So let me enlarge my screen. Guys, you can see open source research framework is not only a single a tool, it consists of some cool tools like checkfi, domainfi, mailfi, phonefi, searchfi, usefi. So don't worry, I'm gonna explain you regarding every module that's available in the open source research framework. So let me clear my screen. So now let's discuss about domainfi.py, which helps us to find the domains that are containing a particular name. Okay, so you can read the description over here. Checks the domain names under the words and nicknames. Okay, so let me come to my clear terminal, and in order to launch this tool, you can simply type domain. If you hit tab, domainfi.py, hit enter, so that it will show you some options. So the main option we'll be targeting on is -n, and guys, this -n option is important throughout this tool, because you'll understand it when it comes over here. And -N if you want to perform it on some group of users, on group of targets. And -t is for threats, and -- who is which checks for who is lookup, which is necessary for the domain file. So what we'll be going to do is domain phi dot py, and I'm gonna specify my whois. I want to look into the whois lookup, and my nickname will be Satvik one. Okay, I don't know. So I gave my name over here. Let me hit enter. So it will try to search for all the things. So it is searching for cool things like Satvik.com. Yeah, and some stuff like that. But at here, you can, in the table, you can see something like Satvik.com is available. And guys, this is not mine. Okay, so so I don't have any domain right now. And these are some of the domains it found. So you can see over here. And you can also find it in the profiles.csv file. Okay, but that's not necessary all the time. So guys, this is everything regarding domain 5. What it does is, it tries to find out the domains or websites which are containing this nickname. Okay, so that's everything regarding domain 5. And let me clear my screen once again. You can simply hit it by Control L. Okay, don't need to type clear L, clear. So now the next module we'll be focusing on is mail file, which is also included in open source OSRF. Okay. Think let me open a new tab and it will be easy for me. Okay, let me open a new tab and hit OSRF so that we can quickly jump into this tab and we can view the stuff that's associated with this particular module. So we completed with the domain file, and now in the mail file, what it checks is we'll provide a nickname over here, and this tries to gather some email addresses that are associated with that name. Like suppose if I came Satvik, it will check for whether Satvik @gmail.com is available. Like that, it will search for 20 to 30 domains. Okay, so let me show that for you. Mailfy, and let me hit enter so that we can view the options for the first time. And same again, minus n is our god over here. So let me clear my screen. Mailfy.py and minus n. So I have a mail called nullshark.satvik. Okay, so let this be my nickname. Okay, or you can simply give Satvik. Okay, since in order to show you the proof, I'm giving my original one of my mail. Okay, this is not my main mail. Let me hit enter. So it will search for things like nullshark.satvik@protonmail.ch, protonmail.com and stuff like that. So it's going to take some time definitely, but you need to have patience because you don't need to search for everything. Like the traditional passive reconnaissance is like you need to go to the browser and you need to search for the stuff. Okay, but this tool is giving everything for you. So let this tool run for some time. Okay, since it is searching for 39 mail platforms, and in the meantime, let's look into another tool. Which is check file. Let's look into check file is not useful because it's set for email address, which is same like mail file. We don't need to consider check file here. But what we'll consider here is phone file, which is really cool. So let this run. We'll come to this page after some time. Let me open a new tab and let me run my command phone file dot. Py. And guys, you don't need to give Python 3 or stuff like that. These are built-in commands and these are in user bin. So yeah, don't need to give anything. Just run what I'm doing over here. Let me hit enter and here we can see some options. So what PhoneFi does is it will look for the mobile number in some spam websites. Like if you got a mobile number, you can search whether the particular number is spam or not. So I can't provide a original number over here because it comes against the guideline strikes, but you can check it out. Phone5.py, once again, minus n, which is nickname. Let me give 9876543210. Guys, I can't give any number here because it's against the YouTube strike, YouTube community guidelines. So you can try that out on your number as well. Okay, so this is also going to take some time. Yes, but it completed faster. So it is trying to find out the details about this particular number in some websites which are against the spam. Okay, so you can simply check it. You can simply go to this link and you can check the details about it as well. So yeah, so that's everything regarding the phone file. And once again, let me go to the this mail file. It is checking for, I think it's completed. So in the meantime, let me give brief about this phone file. What it does is we provide a mobile number here, and this tool checks for this number in some popular websites, which helps us to find whether a number is spam or not. So you can simply copy this link and you can view in your browser of any browser of your choice. I think our mail file is completed. Look. Guys, you can look how detailed this tool is. It is looking for some 39 mail providers, which are mostly popular, joho.com and stuff like that. And guys, you can see it's completed. The linked accounts are nullshock.sathvik@gmail.com, which is one of my mail, and also nullshock.sathvik@protonmail.com, which is also one of my mail address. I don't mail do this. I don't actually see them most of the time. And once again, it is verifying the email addresses in other platform as well. Previously, it checked in one platform and then it is checking in another platform. And guys, the some cool thing is, if you provide the API key for the Have I Been Pwned, it will search whether the particular email is have been pwned or not. Means whether the email addresses credentials are leaked online or not previously. Okay, so let this go on and let's discuss about another tool, which is Searchify, which is really cool for me. What it does is it will try to search in different search engines regarding a particular query. So let me go to my new tab. Okay, Control L to clear my screen, and Searchify.py. And here in this tool, you don't have something like -n for nicknames. Instead, you have something like -q for query, which is required. So let me show you how this tool works. -q and the query be Sathvik TechTuber, which is my name, which is my channel name. Let me hit enter. So it will again search for some more platforms. You can see the Facebook, GitHub, Instagram and stuff. And guys, I don't literally use them. It haven't found anything. Okay, so let me try. I think I should show you something. Okay, let me try on Sathvik, because there are many people with the name Sathvik, and you can definitely find some of them. Okay, so once again, in the meantime, you got some couple of them, and don't expect that all of these are mine. Okay, all of these are not mine. I think my GitHub profile is not what I mentioned, and you got something like that. Okay, so that's everything regarding the search file. It searches for a particular nickname, particular query on all the available websites, on all the available platforms like Facebook, GitHub, Instagram, Key Server, Twitter and YouTube. Okay, so that's everything guys regarding the search file tool. And so it's not even completed. It is looking into much more stuff. This mail file is looking into much more stuff. I think you need to wait for some time. So then I think it will complete. So guys, we currently completed with the domain file, mail file, phone file and search file. Now let's discuss about use file, which is like one of my previous video where I featured Sherlock, which tries to find out the names of username that with a particular username in all available platforms like Facebook, stuff like that. So Usefy is same like that. So in order to launch this, I think it's clear right now till now. Let me Usefy.py. Let me hit enter, and guys, you can see some options over again here. And this is also same, -n is fine for this. And let me hit Sathvik TechTuber once again, and in order to specify the list, you need to give -l -N. Okay, so it's not even completed. It's searching in for the detail, which is really good. Okay, so let this go on, and I think this is going to take some time, because it's going to find out in 216 platforms, which is not an easy task. Yeah, this is also same like a Sherlock. And when I look into the source code, what I found was it is using same what this open source research framework is using. Yeah, that's a simple code, but he made some tweaks. Okay, yeah, you can use that tool as well, but this is a complex like all-in-one tool. Yeah, our MailFi results are completed. It has searched for many search engines and stuff, and it, after doing some good amount of research and stuff, yeah, all these results are correct. I have an account in gmail.com as well as in Proton Mail, so you can touch this website. And I had given nullshock.sathvik because I know that there are some mails with this particular username, and you can give it on any target. Suppose if you are having something like Sathvik, and if you want to hack a Sathvik, you can simply look into that and you can get the information. So guys, that's everything regarding the MailFi. But while running MailFi, make sure that you have some patience, little bit of patience, because it took approximately 5 minutes, I hope so. Yeah, 5 minutes, but that's not a big deal. And now let's come to the Usufi. Let me hit Control C so that I can view something data, like the data that is collected till now. Most of them, I don't know. Okay, I don't know most of them upon Hub. Okay, I don't know. I don't have an account there over there. SathvikTechTuber.su.io. Yeah, I don't know about that. And this is the real one. You can follow me out there. And YouTuber, YouTube also. I also have a YouTube account. So it completed some part of the scan, but not all the part, because we terminated in the middle. Okay, so guys, that's everything regarding this open source research framework, which helps you to perform the passive reconnaissance in an easier way. If you like this video, please like it and do subscribe to my channel for more amazing content like this. And if you're having any doubts regarding the installation or on how to use that, you can simply comment below. I can help you out. So thank you for watching this video. This is Sathvik signing off.